You and I do not understand the power of habit. It will help you or it will destroy you. Let me give you an example. A little compromise does not have a big effect. If I eat something bad, 1 day, 2 days, it doesn't affect me. So in my mind, oh, it's okay to break this habit. But pretty soon, after 1 year, 2 years of not taking care of my body properly, eating properly, 5 years, 10 years, it will begin to affect my kidney, my liver. Yes or no? The same thing is spiritually. You may think, well, if I have quiet time every day, I suggest those of you starting this week, in the morning, devote 5, 10, 15 minutes for the Lord. Agree? Everybody say that with me. First 10, 15 minutes, do it. It's a small thing. But once you start doing that small thing, you can improve the habit. But you cannot improve any habit until you develop a habit. Are we clear? So the habit of getting up in the morning, having time with the Lord, it becomes a habit. Don't make it too hard. If you make it too hard, look, you must have a trigger. My son tells me his trigger is no cell phone in the house, in the room. When you wake up in the morning, you don't look at cell phones. You pray first, do all of those. No social media. Get this trigger, the wrong kind of trigger, away from you. Bible, audio Bible. Eventually it becomes a habit, it's a desire. You respond and you'll be amazed. The pleasure of meeting the Lord. It's a cycle. So this week challenge, develop one habit that will contribute to the one thing, intimacy with God. What is that habit you will develop? Well, I suggest in the morning time, or giving, whatever it is,